Necromancy Emmy, you never shut the fuck up about.
Oh man.
Zartal began to recite the spell. Standing tall on the wings of my dreams. Rise and fall on the wings of my dream.
That spell sounds pretty familiar, pretty close to the Perfect Strangers theme.
Yeah, but they never heard it in Darinos.
Yeah, but that's what's great about Darinos is that a lot of things that exist in our world exist in theirs, and it's just, that's the way it is.
Yeah, who's to say that we didn't get it from them, you know?
Yeah, true.
I mean,
it's
canon.
It's canon.
Suddenly, the earth began to quake as if
it showered him with fake golden coins. The town was poor, after all. Mm-hmm. As Thaddeus walked into the center of town, he sang.
Here we stand, bound forevermore. We're out of this world until the end. Here we are, mighty glorious at the end of the rainbow with gold in our hands.
Dude. Fucking awesome.
Those are lyrics from a ridiculous Hammerfall song. With at the end of the rainbow with gold in our hands.
With gold in our hands. Well, that
all
makes
right,
sense.
Whatever, sure, why not? You're talking about rainbows and gold.
It's no battle keg.
It's
lyrics.
No battle keg. But it's pretty good.
It's all
thin.
Right. Beautiful. I love it. Dude.
Cauldron. The wizard seemed to be in some sort of trance. He placed this staff into the cauldron as his eyes went black and mouth opened. He began to stir the cauldron as a demonic voice spoke. Mama's little baby loves shortening, shortening. Mama's little baby loves shortening bread. Mama's little baby loves shortening, shortening. Mama's little baby loves shortening bread. They're all done.
It's the love that makes the spell work.
So true.
So was he with that? He was singing that just like in a trance, like his mouth is like all agape, and he just
He's like uncontrolled, a demonic voice. That was demons.
That did sound like demons. It did.
Out of the cauldron crawled a disgusting. Oh! Suddenly, the wizard heard something in a room close to him. He pressed himself against the wall and peered in. What he saw was one of the most unspeakable things he ever did see. A skeleton wearing seven hats taking a magical shower. And the skeleton was singing. Oh yeah, I'm the hat skeleton. And every day I make the lady say, let me get a hat for my baby back home. Cause he's a little baby man and I love him. But I say no. I'm the skeleton man with the hat addiction. It's unhealthy. And you know I just got a big old bony body, boy. Kiss me on my skeleton lips. You monster! He yelled Fright Door. And he did a roundhouse kick that shot a spell out of his foot. And it hit the hat. And the hat melted. How could you? I was the hat skeleton! Shouted the skeleton as he fell to his knees.
Beautiful.
Yeah, and also, the dragon, he's singing you a song.
Oh, man.
And it's going like this. If you wanna ride on my back, you gotta kiss my scales.
Oh, beautiful.
And if you don't, then I'll toss you right off. JK, I love you.
Aww.
Dragon song.
I wish to be the most powerful dwarf of all time, Biggles said right away.
Krasnor let out a hearty laugh, then began to sing a Disney-esque song. If you want to become king, you must make me sing. This is your final wish. Make it your carefulest.
What?
Then a bird flew down and landed on his shoulder and immediately burst into flames, then flew away all on fire. The stripper mummy was still twerking and stripping.
What the shit is happening?
After a moment, nothing noticeable had happened.
And there, stood in front of Radagast, was a skeleton with 7 hats on.
Oh, what the fuck? And suddenly the skeleton started singing.
My heart's been assassinated by my ex-girlfriend. I caught her kissing a half-orc goblin elf last night on my birthday. I couldn't believe it, and they was Frenching. It was so hot, steam was coming off of them. He was buff and she felt so safe into his muscles. And I'm just a bony boy. Baby, come back to my heart. Resurrect my love tonight. Oh, XOXO. God. Hat skeleton. And he tipped his 7 hats.
Oh my god, I fucking love this skeleton so goddamn much.
Radagast was confused. Who the shit are you? He yelled for the last time. Slaves, how about a little lifting music for this maggot? A couple of orcs stepped forward and started singing as Koroth grabbed hold of the bar. Now all the masters know that you need the glow. You need the glow to grow to grow. If you love to live, you live to love. But you gotta move to the upper level. Cause when you got the glow, there ain't no stopping what you want to do. Ho!
Oh my god. Beautiful.
That's what the orc sang. Koroth lifted the bar off the bench, and it immediately dropped to his chest. The slavers all began to laugh. Koroth struggled to lift the bar, but it wouldn't move. The orcs continued singing. To reach that upper level, your mind, body, and soul must be one. It's a sacrifice. It takes hard work. It's a way of life. Suddenly, Koroth began lifting the massive weight up. One of the orcs known simply as Diamond started crumping.
Diamond!
He was doing handstands, headstands, dick stands, all kinds of crazy shit. Seriously, dude was spinning on his boner. The slavers were stunned. The orcs continued. When you got that glow, you feel the one. When you got that glow,
dude,
your body's gold, so don't let go of the power of elevation. Talk about that glow. One orc stepped forward. Shine on.
He's
with
like the
one
end.
Last push, Koroth completed his rep. What did you want to say?
Just like, he like steps out of the line and he does it.
Yeah, he was like, shine on.
Yeah, I gotcha.
The entire cave was silent, and all of a sudden, Koroth...
Go on an adventure, snapped Zaffle.
Okay, cool. Hey, let me sing you slow jam to help you go back to sleep. Hey, baby, we're gonna be adventuring all over this sexy-ass earth. And I felt your love when you were inside me. I also saw your butt through your butt flapper. Girl, I didn't pay it no mind. I liked the way you work it.
Ron, get the fuck out of my room, Zaffle yelled as he cut Ron off.
I didn't pay it no mind.
Oh, shit. The next morning came, and the roosters all crowed loud as shit. Ron was already outside, waiting to depart for a moment. Great. Now we're stuck here forever, Zaffle sighed.
Now what'll help pass the time? Ron asked. Hey, baby, we're gonna be adventuring all up in a sexy lava pit, baby. You're all up in my Ferrari guts.
The end.
Great story.
10 gold pieces then? Replied Thaddeus.
Actually, I'm running a special today. Mapping a song for 12 pieces. Sounds fair, I'll take it, said Daniel. The two made the exchange. Then Daniel cleared his throat and sang. It's the remix to Ignition, hot and fresh out the kitchen. Mama rolling that body, got every man in here wishing. Sipping on coke and rum, I'm like, so what, I'm drunk. It's the freaking weekend, baby, I'm about to have Mr. Bun.
Dude, that shit is a hit in any world.
Dude, I think it's gonna be a big song.
How is he not famous yet? He's selling maps still?
He gotta push the maps first. Can you get the gold for saying it?
Maps is where the money is. Maps is where the money is.
Thaddeus was impressed. There was much applause and no maiden in Trademan's port.
Harry closed his eyes and raised his arms up in preparation of being cut in twain. But the slice never came. Opening his eyes, Perry saw Fripp bicycle kicking Harry in the face, his tiny little chipmunk legs pumping so quickly that he was using Harry's face as a speed bag. All the while, Fripp was singing, baby, 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 oh my baby, 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 you're my baby, baby. It was a song that Fripp made up and sang all the time, but no one but Fripp liked, but he always claimed had gone triple, quadruple platinum in his home dimension.
Oh my god, Fripp.
Harry's body slumped to the ground as Fripp perfectly executed.
Tweezers and Lamb Chop nearly pissed their baby-sized diapers in disbelief. The elementals continued to sing their tune. Oh, we are rock guys, and we chop up rocks and make new ones because some of them look like boobs, and others kind of look like balls. If you find one that looks like a wiener, send it to my baby tonight.
So they go around randomly punching boobs and balls.
Yeah, they just like break up
they
rocks.
They could be like female rock men, right?
They could. There's female rock men, yeah. But that's the song. They gotta sing
okay.
That song.
Gotcha. Okay, makes sense.
They haven't broken through the rock ceiling yet and made a song just about dicks. Lanchop, we found them! The rock elementals of the Ghostly Vale Mountain! Music created a shield around Jeremy and blocked him from harm. Then he began to sing. Canterbury, I wanna fuck your sister so bad. One time she called me and I was like, whoa, you boobs. She has a nice butt and I think her ass nips are so red. Then the dragon jizz floated and like six ass hymens were thrown up on stage.
This may be your filthiest story.
It gets worse. The crowd cheered as Jeremy walked off stage. Canterbury walked past him and ran into him on purpose like a total dickhead would do. Canterbury tuned his magical lute with the band's name on the codpiece. Then Canterbury began to sing. Jeremy, your mom and I are moving in together. Clean out your old room, cause that's where our sex swing's gonna go. I'm gonna tie your mom up with my enchanted jizz and leather.
What? Whose jizz can wrap people up and imprison them?
That's the stupidest thing ever. Who wrote this shit? Jesus. The crowd went nuts and Jeremy's mom flashed her cooter to Canterbury. The smell alone caused the first row to soil their diapers.
Arena of Orcspire, sponsored by Wizard Pizza Tower. Wizards all over were casting crazy slight spells that were going like
yes.
No, that song wasn't playing, but you know right. How they were casting spells.
Now you know how, yeah. It's canon.
A goblin in a very nice suit walked out from the dressing room. Soon, Kirstens. Soon. But first, said the announcer, the national anthem. And a beautiful elf in a really nice dress walked down into the ring, grabbed the mic, and sang, oh, sand in my peen. I got sand in my peen. I'll just pee the sand out and my peen will feel better. But my pee splits in half, and my pee smells real bad, 'cause my pee went everywhere, and I peed on my girlfriend's rug that's at the foot of her toilet. But seriously, she shouldn't put that there. Guys pee all over. I'll just clean up the sea and not say anything.
Dude, dumb. That is way better than our national anthem. Fuck you, America.
You want to know why? Because it came from the heart.
It's true.
It's a true thing.
Yeah, 100%.
Ladies, guys pee on your rugs.
All the time.
The crowd was stunned. Then, all of a sudden, the beautiful lady did a backflip and revealed that the beautiful lady was actually Salami, the magical goblin.
Yay!
Everyone laughed. He winked and said, "Have fun, y'all," and disappeared.
I love him.
Me too. The announcer grabbed the mic and spoke again. "Just for clarification, that was not the National Anthem of Forkspire." Anyway, your first combatant, Forkspire, weighing a crazy amount of muscly weight, Luscious Larry. Fireworks shot out of everywhere, definitely hitting some fans and burning their faces, but they did not care. Luscious Larry's music played, and it went like this. "Sometimes I wish I could fuck myself." With curly, long brown hair, a large
cold
Warrock, now super buff, with a skull painted on his face and wearing a leather vest with skulls on it, walked down the ramp and into the ring. His music went like this. "Don't you know I'm a skeleton's friend? Friend of the skeletons." Since his encounter with the bandits in the forest, he began lifting bone weight.
Next roar. Kyle Gagnon asks, "What is the best way to soothe a raging orc?"
BOGO sales.
BOGO sales?
Buy one, get one sales. They love that shit here.
I have to admit, that would soothe me.
It's amazing. You buy one here and you get one.
A deal of any kind. My word.
It's crazy awesome. What about you, Snickerdoodle?
In Orkspire, the old-fashioned way is to soothe with a song, and, well, the song I sing is, "Take a little trip to the pain mine, baby. Take a little trip to the pain mine, baby. Sex with me is like the pain mines, baby. Three people have died having sex with me, baby. Actually, maybe that's a bad idea, baby. Okay, I'll scroll you another time, baby."
Snickerdoodle, that was beautiful.
Thank you, I've been writing it for days.
Three people actually had died from having sex with you?
Well, it's just a story.
Oh. I was going to ask how...
Well, maybe... it's a good time for a rumor, maybe. Yes, I'm, four have died, actually.
Oh my god, Snickerdoodle.
Nope. And you can visit their ghosts... and ask them how good it was. It was real good.
Any publicity is good publicity, Snickerdoodle.
Next scroll, just read the next scroll.
Next scroll is kind of final.
Next scroll.
Next scroll is from Ariel Beltran. What are some of the favored lullabies in your prospective land, Snickerdoodle?
Take a little trip to the pain mine, baby. Take a little trip to the pain mine, baby. Sex with me is like the pain mines, baby. You know how the rest of it goes.
It's so good. It's so good. Please, yes. I want a cassette
tape. What's this? Hold on. There's a scroll coming in now.
Here we go.
Big record deal. Thousands of gold. Record this hot hit. Reese's, I think I've got an opportunity here.
I think you should.
And frankly, maybe I don't need to do Chamber of Knowledge anymore.
I would be a very bad friend if I said you shouldn't do this.
Why don't you take a look at the scroll I just got?
Okay, hold on. Let me grab
it. It was a prank! It's blank!
Oh,
I would never leave!
I love having a good time.
You can't leave because you can't even walk properly. So, of course.
You had to bring up my lame legs.
They're still pretty to me, Snickerdoodle.
That's why I like hang glider. It's like I'm flying.
I will sing you a lullaby to help you soothe your sleep, to put you to sleep.
Thank you. Please do.
Go to sleep, or you'll die. Then you'll never be awake again. Don't drink salt water, or you'll die. And you'll never see your mommy. Good night, everyone. This ends another episode of Chamber of Knowledge.
I'll take a trip to the pain mom. Pain!
Till next time, good night.
Which is rumored to be haunted. Mm-hmm. A goblin was sitting on a stump, equipped with leather pants and a lute. He was strumming the lute as he sang a song, yielding adventurers. Oh, listen, all ye travelers, beware of the swamp. It's got ghosts, and you know that's spooky. I took my girlfriend on a date there. She didn't like it. I got broke up with 3 months later. I know that's kind of a long time, but I think it's because I took her to that swamp. It also could have been because she caught me kissing a sexy fish. It's not my fault. I love women.
I just love how, like, this guy's like dwelling on the fact that he took her to the swamp for a date, and that's the reason that she broke up with him.
That's the only reason that he could come up with.
He's like, that's gotta be it. I know that's the reason.
Barbarian, spoke the goblin. Heed my song. Do not go in the swamp. The souls of the dead haunt the waters. You may be walking along, and you, like, think you see a person out of the corner of your eye, and then you look, and it's just a tree branch that kind of looks like a person's face, you know? Or, like, you see a twig, and it starts floating, but there ain't no strings or nothing. Creepy shit, man. Fuck twigs, said the barbarian, and he grabbed the goblin by the neck, chewed on his entire head for a little bit, and tossed him aside all bit up. The goblin whispered, I'll never be a star now.
Oh my god. He had dreams.
That was his stardom. He was like, you know, playing outside of a swamp, and then, you know,
he was hoping to get
Johnny
discovered.
Record deal. Yeah.
Johnny Record scroll deal.
Scroll deals. Though the sun shined in Orkspire, the swamp was pitch black. Raining blood across the work spire. Lightning struck, and when it did, it went.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Gorlock returned to the mead hall, flipped his table back over, and ordered another round of mead for. Other than that, what do you say we get into some fantasy?
Yeah! Are we sandstorming?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, that's fantasy. That's what fantasy sounds like.
Come on,
Zane. Sounds like sandstorm.
They're just to feel feelings other than the dark thoughts in their own tortured mind. Axel began to sing. Are you hitting on my dead wife? Don't you know she's just a pile of dead bones? We're gonna rip out your throat and piss down your neck holes. Pile of bones, pile of stones, pile of groans. As they did so, Canterbury and Dogwings were flying all the fuck around.
The sound of gorg crickets filled the evening.
Oh, what are those?
It sounded like this. Panama, Panama.
Holy shit.
Oh my god.
Inside a dark wizard tower, a tired figure ascended him as he closed his eyes. He pushed the now glowing battle staff forward and began to chant. I wanna lick you from your head to your toes, and I wanna move to the bed, down to the floor, and I wanna make it so good, I'm gonna leave, and I wanna what your fantasy.
I kind of fucked up that chant a little bit.
That was great.
No, no.
You get it.
That was perfect.
It was good.
I was like, am I listening to Luda? Is this the Luda cast?
Suddenly before him appeared a cloud of black smoke and out stepped a fine-ass fuck-you-bus, which is kind of like a succubus, but also has the ability to hate fuck. She was tit-ass naked, and that...
Ugla wasn't done. She cornered the Duchess and pointed her sword and her staff at her. Sid finished an awesome parkour move and walked over. Just as he did, Ugla started chanting the magical incantation. You packed and you stacked, especially in the back. Brother, want to thank your mother for a butt like that. Then she slapped Sid's firmly toned butt cheeks. As she did, the Duchess suddenly grew old before their eyes.
Damn!
Old and ugly as fucking shit, and then started twerking hard. Then she exploded.
I imagine that twerking was not comfortable.
Good. Second trial. The trial of seduction. Whisper lyrics of a love song to each other,
bellowed the demon, and Tootlin started whispering. Whoop, whoop, pull over that ass too fat. Whoop, whoop, pull over that ass too fat.
He's just whispering.
Good. Good.
Familiar face. It was Jimmy Treebranch and his familiar Mr. Yakitori. Yo, killer prank at the druid prom, guys, Jimmy said. I mean, turning into a flying laser spell wielding double headed raptor and dive bomb spiking the punch bowl with orc urine, then pantsing Dean Oxford with the pantsing spell, then hoisting him up the flagpole while getting the entire school to sing the Druid Academy fight song? Classic. Then Jimmy began to sing. We are the druids of the Druid Academy. We come from all over Daranos. Saber eagles, saber cats, hot dogs fight. We love the motherfucking goddamn shit out of you, Druid Academy.
Wait, like if I was walking down the street and I had done something, and some guy was like, oh my god, you did that thing. Remember when you did that thing? And then sang the song I sang?
Yeah.
Well, Tom, you obviously never went to Penn State, man. That was like every day there.
It's pretty accurate.
You're right.
Thanks, Jimmy, Dingle said as he and Billy opened.
Tell Mom I'm not hungry. I've got work to do. The Seeing Stone suddenly busted out the fucking raddest song ever. Nah, 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 come on. Credits began to roll, and people started making their way out of the theater. These idiots didn't realize that there was an after-credit scene, and they stopped in the aisle and turned around.
Their way out of the labyrinth. As the two exited, they heard somewhere in the halls the echoes of a song that went, Hoagie, when I'm with you, I'm not hungry. You're my toasted little turkey, baby. The end.
Dude, that so was good. Great. Great story.
Yo, need Thank that last you. Part as my ringtone.
Dude, seriously.
You're my toasted little turkey, baby.
Oh, my God.
Oh, shit.
Gas, pussy ass, boner ass losers. Am I doing it right, Snickerdoodle?
Don't you know, no. You know. Come around, yeah. What? That's a little song for people who are thinking about getting wise with Reese's the Wise.
You're like the best hype man I've ever had, Snickerdoodle. I've
been doing it for years.
You're the only hype man I've
been
ever
had. Freelance hype manning.
Freelance hype manning?
Yes, it's not busy work, but when I get it, it's enjoyable.
It's not busy work, but it's fulfilling work.
Yes, very rewarding.
What about you, Snickerdoodle? Well, I scored a 13,000% on Wizard Rotten Tomatoes, so yeah. Reese's is ranked pretty high.
Dip damn.
13,000%. That's not even Pretty Woman has that many percents. Dances with Wizard Wolves.
I don't know if you noticed, but I was doing my hype. I was hyping.
You were hyping the shit out of me, Snickerdoodle. You're hired again.
Thank you. It'll be a pleasure to work with my favorite client.
What about you, Snickerdoodle?
Funnily enough,
enough, that is what Wizard Cheers is all about, making new friends.
Where everybody knows your name, Snickerdoodle.
But sometimes you want a potion to drink that'll make you die.
Those are the lyrics to the song.
Yes, this is Wizard Cheers. It's different from your cheers. And, you know, if I do say so myself, you people have heard enough information from our worlds. Possibly too much. But thanks, everyone, for listening to another show. And until next week, Josh.
Until next week, keep on wizarding.
Keep on wizarding down the wizarding road. Pull on the hammer. That's a thing in a truck. Gonna put on some truck nuts that are green.
Or
put them
nuts
on the back of my ATV. Go at max speed till my mama says, get inside for supper.
And when you say supper, there's a guitar that goes, yeah, man.
And demons are summoned. The end.
Goodbye.
Bye. But hey, why don't we say we get into the world of a little fantasy?
Fantasy!
Oh. I'm sorry, that was my electronic piccolo.
Your electricolo? Oh, shit.
Daranos, toss the old turnip around with your son. I don't know when, but we'll get together then. You know we'll have a good time then. In the cats in the cradle in the silver moon. Oh, little boy moon and the man in the moon.
Oh, this song is bringing a tear to my wizard eye. Did you write that? That is beautiful.
I didn't not write it.
I believe you. You know, my dad never used to throw the turnip around with me.
We should do it. We should throw the turnip around together sometimes, Snickerdoodle.
You think we could do that?
No, because we are rickety as hell and old.
Oh, yes, that time has passed. The only thing we throw these days are dope-ass parties.
That's very true.
Next scroll.
Johnny! Princess climbed on top, and together they rode off into space. Back at the cultist clubhouse, an elder cultist was double bong hitting some wizard weed.
Damn.
Smoke on the water. Sometimes I turn into guys. Smoke on the water. I'm a totally cool warlock guy. Oh shit, I forgot to pick up Carl. The end.
Greg's mouth began to water as he fantasized an endless chain of anthropomorphic assassin dogs happily strutting into his mouth while he sang, Papa loves Mambo, boop-a-doop-boop-boop, Mama loves Mambo, boop-a-doop-boop-boop. A voice came on the... They're just dancing in there, man.
This is just a story about a guy who wants to eat hot dogs.
This is a story about the greatest hot dog celebration of all time, man. Ready for this? A voice came on the PA and began to cheer, What do we love? Greg and the ravenous crowd around him responded, Hot dogs! What do we hate? Not dogs! What makes us eat more? Pot dogs! What are we made of? Mechanically separated meat byproduct, phosphates, fillers, preservatives, and sheep intestines. That actually wasn't the right response to the last question. It was supposed to be badass Amazonian ass-kickery. But to be fair, this night was pretty much turning into a 100% pure hot dog party.
How are you supposed to know any of the answers to those chants?
They love hot dogs, man. It's the hot dog chant. You haven't gone to a dollar dog night in a while, have you?
No, I haven't in a while.
That's the truth.
Hey, yo, Crumbs, hit your boy with a dag.
Lay about the ground. A tumble skeleton blew through. Damn, some fucked up shit just went down. Hail, shouted the traveler. My name is Shiana Fellcutter. Is anyone alive? No answer. She began to walk into town, and as she did, this song played out of nowhere.
Yeah, well, she's a tall Amazon babe, and you know you want to kiss her, but you can't, because if you did, your lips would become crippled, because that's how hot slash tough she is. You would get crippled lips, and you would have to wear a cast on your lips. Also, don't try to double cross her, because she'll totally throw a javelin into your pee hole.
Wow.
Oh, my God.
Oh, shit.
As the Amazon began to search the town, I continued telling you about her. Little was known about Shiana, except for this other song that went like this. Her family was killed by demons. Then they were resurrected by a skeleton necromancer, and they were skeleton warriors, and she had to kill her family's skeletons. Then the demons were summoned, and they used her family's bones as weapons. Guys, she hates demons.
Dude, you're a master of exposition. Put it in song.
Yeah. I'm also a master of song, first and foremost.
First and foremost, yeah. This is like The Hobbit, but better.
She approached a body lying face first on the ground.
You are his brother. I will do anything to kick that son of a bitch death in the fucking dick. Give me your dagger hand, the old man demanded. Taking the dagger, he cut off two of Sid's fingers and then said some magical shaman incantation. Someday love will find you. Break those chains that bind you. One night will remind you, if he ever hurts you, true love won't desert you. Though we touched, we went our separate ways. Suddenly, Kid awoke. He was alive. Sid hugged him, but Kid didn't seem to know who Sid was at all.
What do we gotta say? We haven't said it in a week.
Oh, I don't know if I remember. Just kidding, I totally fucking remember. Keep on wizarding!
Keep on wizarding! Come on to my house, baby. Open the door. You're gonna see me in a robe. I'm making breakfast. It's 7 o'clock at night. Yeah, I'm eccentric.
I'm eccentric. Beautiful.
Did I say electric or centric? Eccentric.
I think you said eccentric.
Well, that's what I meant, but electric is real funny. Keep on wizarding, everybody. Have a good week.
Bye.
Enough wizard we concentrate in his brain that he could only appreciate things in the fourth dimension or higher anyways. He stepped forward, grasped the neck of the guitar, then quickly but gently removed the condom placed over its neck. As Brozef tuned the guitar, his wakened mind dreaming of the badassery he, as the prophet of the volcano Steve, would unleash upon Megathul, he began to sing a song not heard on Megathul in generations.
Oh, God.
With a clear voice, as badass as it was beautiful, he sang, hey, 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 smoke wizard weed every day. As he repeated the refrain, Hagatha began casting a spell of eldritch powers.
The suns were sweltering, so to take their mind off the heat, they'd sing working songs that went a little like this. Let me get up in your prison, baby. Sentence my dick to life.
Shit,
my
man.
Injection can be lethal, baby. I'ma make you my wizard prison wife.
That's beautiful.
And we gonna have a little baby. And you gonna raise that little baby. And that baby's gonna break me out of this wizard prison.
Damn.
Baby breaking me out tonight.
That was me and Queenie's first dance as man and wife.
Oh, was it?
Yeah. That song.
That's a good choice.
Something told me.
Something told me. I just knew. I looked in your eyes.
I can't
just
hear
knew.
It, but I'm crying.
Man, I can hear it. Cut to the prison waiver. Super awesome zoom in shot where we fly through everything on our way to the silhouette and reveal that it is a babely witch.
Ow! Oh,
with
shit.
Floating magic ball performing some sort of curse. She chanted the spell's most evil runes. Oh, yeah. Wanna be my lover.
Oh, shit, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Wanna be my lover.
That's beautiful. That was really good.
Thanks.
There are eldritch magics in those words.
Yeah. Yeah, man.
Atavistic power courses through them.
Suddenly.
Suddenly.
Tony's eyes begin to glow.
To tell you what kind of flute it is. It is the flute of pure moods.
Pure moods flute. That's
I decided I did want to tell you. Just in that moment, because it's important. It's the flute of pure moods.
It's your prerogative, Snickerdoodle. Unbelievably beautiful.
Return to innocence. That's what comes out of that flute. The flute of pure moods.
Does it do the X-Files theme?
Yes, take a trip into the unknown with the X-Files theme. Anyway, suddenly out of the ocean emerged a horrifying sea. You could ask each other one question, what would it be?
Snickerdoodle, I would ask you, don't you want me, baby? Don't you want me? Oh, that's what I would ask you.
That is a good question, but I counter with a question of my own, which is, yes. Why do you hate me?
I don't hate you.
That's not what you were dreaming about last night. I saw you dream
yourselves into the ground, except for Branch Grand, who wandered into the forest. As he did, this song began to play.
Reflection time. Oh, what did I do all those things for? Why was I such a bad tree man? I could have been a good one, but Daddy never said he loved me. Aww. Wait, do I even have a dad? How does this work? Reflection time.
That song hits a little too close to home, Dom.
Yeah, well, hey.
Do you need a break?
Truth and comedy, guys.
Truth and good. Truth and tragedy.
Branch of Gran looked up at the moons.
Morty a rare moment of peace alone in his magical shop of enchanted cloaks. Man, I love my job, he said contentedly. He picked a piece of Murkmunk fur off of a regal-looking purple cloak as he began to sing a song. I love cloaks. Fucking all kinds of dope-ass cloaks. Call me Cloak Daddy, baby, cause Daddy's got some cloaks. Girl, you wanna fuck a rich dude?
Just singing this little song?
To himself.
To his piece of Murkmunk fur.
Yeah. Oh, that sounded adorable. Just then, the front door chime rang, and in walked... Ludacritz dodged the first punch and then let forth some sick rhymes. Ma, period, fresh, comma. Your wife is my baby mama. God damn motherfucker. She's a good dick sucker. What?
So he just rapped and beat this guy.
Yeah, dude.
I like it. I like this Ludacritz.
I think what you just described was actually a scene from that Def Jam Fight for New York.
Oh, man. As he finished, the bandits were totally schooled. One exploded into fire right then and there.
A little warlock. Please knock. Please be the ice cream man. The wizard knocked, but to no answer. The door was unlocked. Frightmore pushed it open. A fire was burning as a warlock sat in a chair watching a few floating conjured skulls who were singing. Doo-wop, doobie-doo-wop, doo-wop-doo-lay. Blue days, black nights, doo-wop-doo-lay. The wizard's danky stank filled the room. Frightnor, shouted the warlock as he got up. Frightnor looked over to see Gandrixel off watching some conjured skulls sing, ya da da dee da da.
Oh my god.
Ya da da dee da 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 da. Gandrixel! Shouted the Frightnor. The warlock quickly dismissed the skulls. With a big swing, the wizard was knocked unconscious by a.
Mitch walked over to his fallen friend. Lenny was crying, but Mitch knew how the little guy would have wanted to go out. He busted out his double-necked electric bone guitar and sang a ballad. Heroes will fall, but respect is forever. Goodbye, little buddy. I'll forget you the day after never. I bet you're up in heaven, kicking Jesus in the ass.
Whoa, Jesus exists in Daranos? Just drop that bombshell?
It's just a figure of speech.
Okay, all right, okay. Shit was about to get real.
Goodbye, friend. I'll never forget you. Mitch held up the horns. Cheep, 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 said a random merc monk who had been beckoned by the sound of the ballad. Oh, hey, little guy. You're the new Lenny, too.
Whoa, how does Lenny feel about that?
Lenny's okay with it, because Lenny's an idiot. Lenny's the dumb
one.
He
just wants company.
Yeah, he just needs a friend. As Mitch said that, an ice eagle soared down from space and scooped them up as Mitch
walked toward the wizard. As he did, the riff from Smoke on the Water played.
Oh, fuck
and
yeah.
Did you know that riff has lyrics? Yep, and they go like this. Big swinging dick, big swinging dick, big swinging dick riff, yeah.
Those are the lyrics. Those are the notes.
Big swinging dick, big swinging dick, big swinging dick riff, yeah. He was unusually tall for a wood elf. Ripped body, as I said. So yeah, he doesn't have a shirt on either.
Soon the two, plus Clancy, were off in search of Fred's sacred relic. To pass the time, Gregory sang many tunes, like Teacups Make the Girls Say, Oh Yummy, I Love Tea, and Always Respect Your Town Wizard, and everyone's favorite, Bitches Ain't Shit, But Sugar and Spice and Everything Nice, which went something like this. Girl, you got a real huge pair of dimples. I'd love to take you out on a date if that's okay with your dad.
That's just so sweet.
I promise to get you home by moon's o'clock, and no funny stuff when I whip out my rock hard credit card to pay for your dinner.
He's got a credit card?
Yeah.
Who gave this booger credit?
Dude, I don't know, man. Weird, though.
Dragon jizzing Christ, boy. You need to sack the tits up.
After about 8 refrains, the fellowship arrived at a very dark and ominous cave. We looked all around. What is this place?
This is the world, my son, boomed the snot giant.
Oh my god.
What does that prophecy say? I mean, you worked really hard to get it. Fred unrolled the golden scroll and read the ancient holy runes. It says, hey, 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 smoke weed every day. The four of them laughed and high-fived as two lightning eagles soared down as the heroes backflipped onto their backs, and Here I Go Again on My Own by Whitesnake played over the credits. Post-credit scene.
Hold on, I gotta sit back down. Finally, the goblin had reached the crystal cave. Its many glowing crystals illuminated the entrance, and Cliff thought he heard someone singing, oh, the crystals are free. Come and get them, baby. Any day of the week. Chilling out butt naked.
Wait, is he butt naked?
That's just what he heard. Cliff took a step toward it when suddenly a giant dark green foot with long, sharp... I just wanted to make a crystal golem, said the goblin through his tears. And a little songbug crawled up to the top of the desk and began singing. A long time ago, they said, in the land of motherfucking Orcspire, a goblin would fight a cyclops. He would fucking build an army of golems to fucking fight the fucking cyclops. Ought to build the crystal golem. The prophecy foretold this. They said that shit a long time ago. That's why they call it a prophecy, yeah. It can be seen before it can fucking propho. You know what I mean, baby? Yeah. I fucking walk down the street and I take my dick out. Just let that stank air out, yeah. I go to the park and walk around with my dick out. I don't fucking care. I'm a grown-ass man and I do what I want, yeah. If you don't like it, then fucking fight me. Fucking try to fight a guy with his dick out. My dick is totally gonna brush up against your arm, yeah. It's fucking bound to happen. I got a 3-pound hanging dope ass dangler. 3 motherfucking pounds of hang down. A stanky tank down. A banky bank down. A rinky rank down. All www.dick, yeah. com/kissmynastytits. Yeah. Oh, I'm an unfuckable piece of trash who eats garbage out of a raccoon's dumpster. Not even the raccoons want this shit. Yeah. It's like apple cores and rusty knives. Yeah. Rest in peace, Angela. The songbook song filled the goblin with inspiration.
Oh my god. Oh my god, I'm crying. Oh shit.
For days he worked feverishly, determined to fulfill the prophecy told in that haunting tune.
Oh my god.
After a straight week of working, the time had come.
The all-metal griffin band Get Griffed set up on stage and started thrashing. A griffin pit formed when they busted out their hit song, Ca-caw! Which goes something like this. Ca-caw, 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 ca-caw. They played it 12 times in a row. Nobody even gave a fart.
Damn.
A bunch of cool griffins in leather vests busted out some six-packs of...
You know why you're here. The skeleton, wearing several hats, stood up and began to sing. Here I stand before the court of love, on trial cause my girlfriend assassinated my heart. She said we was over, but I couldn't let her go. So I made believe we were still going out by hanging out with the porcupine and make believing it was her. And I got the silent treatment. And I had my heart broken in two, and then those parts were broken in two, and I didn't know what to do, so I kissed a porcupine. If that's against the law, then sentence me to 100 years of no loving.
He's still hung up. He's still hung up on this.
That is against the law, and you shall, said the king. Away with this fool. And the guards beat him up bad.
Oh my god. He's like the Bob Dylan of Orcspire.
The next prisoner was thrown before the king. Yes, then you're pretty much married.
Oh.
How about Darinos?
Well, you know, like the song says, when a man loves a woman... Mm-hmm. Can't keep his mind on nothing else.
Mm-hmm.
He proposes with push-ups and probably revs his cool bone car.
Yes, yes, yes. I can relate to this song.
So that's what happens in Darinos. I mean,
well, I don't know if you really got down to any specifics, but we appreciated. That's how you proposed.
Yeah.
To
got turned down, but it was
to
my fleshlight.
You mean the sock? You mean the Vaseline sock? Okay, moving on. Next scroll, final scroll.
Nobody.
But until next week.
Until next week, everybody. Always remember to keep on wizarding.
Keep on wizarding, baby, even if baby. You feel like a goddamn pain mine.
Like the whole pain mine.
If you feel like a pain mine, keep on wizarding, man. It's gonna get better. Have a good week, everyone. See ya.
Bye. Full of muscly lizard men dancing to LaBouche's "Be My Lover."
Yeah.
As soon as he landed, a really long record scratching sound could be heard. All the
dudes were jamming right before that.
Yeah, they are.
Because in case you don't know what that song sounds like, it's oh yeah, wanna be my lover. Yeah, it's been a spell in one of our stories.
Yeah.
I'm not sure which one.
Yeah. It's a spell in real life, too.
Mm-hmm. Make someone fall in love with you.
A booty spell.
Oh, yeah.
All the muscle lizards turned and did a septuple take.
So fast that he burst into flames as a song played.
Yes!
I wrote a song played, and I couldn't think of a song, so I figured I'd let you figure out what that was, Josh.
Okay, a song. All right, all right.
Grinding on a tower. Bursting in the flames.
Oh, yeah.
Grinding on your mama. Licking on her tits.
Whoa, whoa.
Grinding on a motherfucking tap.
That's an exploding.
It got real sexual there.
It did.
About someone's mother.
It did.
Josh, good collab.
Thanks.
Moving on. A skull sat on a shelf of magical ingredients. Watch.
I would like for you.
For you.
To keep on wizarding.
Keep on wizarding down the road. If you stop by a 7-Eleven, go into it and get a Slurpee. Yeah, it's the summer and it's hot. It's officially summer. It started the other day. Wizarding.
Keep on Slurpee.
Keep on slithering.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, what?
Sexy.
All right, everyone. See you next week. Bye-bye.
You'll be fine.
And with that, let's get into some tales and fantasy.
And fiction.
Do-do-do-boo.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
I'm loving tits. After watching this display of true agility and grace, a nearby songbug held up a small sign with a 9.5 written on it, then sang, "That was one of the most beautiful things I ever did see, but I've seen one more thing that was even better. It was me on the ice skating rink getting nasty with my King Kong donger. I was skating in the 36 Olympics, and I landed a crazy backflip, and then I skated backwards and put my hands on my hips and ripped off my nasty jeans, yeah. And then everyone in the whole motherfucking place had their eyes feasting on my donger, my 10-pound badass cigarette smoking, class cutting, stink line having, sonic booming me propeller. And so the cool breeze on my donger while I was school skating backwards got me all excited. And then I popped a boner and fucking balanced on the tip of my dick. And then I just fucking started spinning on it for like 23 minutes. I was harder than a goddamn now and later candy that was left in the freezer. It was so goddamn majestic, a frick frack fair stick, a fing fong phoner, a bing bong boner, a ting tong tonger, a ching chang chonger, a bebop a rock steady, yeah.
A ching chang chonger?
Did that get vaguely racist at the end? Asked the sorcerer.
Oh my god. I can't breathe. Oh my god. Holy shit.
Why do you disturb the Yeti's early lunch break? Shouted the unbathed beast. What do you say, Josh? Until next week.
Until next week. Keep on wizarding.
Keep on wizarding.
Bye.
I'll see you next week, baby.
Kinda wanna kiss you on your lips and tongue,
but I'm afraid it might make you fall right in love.
I'm not even afraid that's what's gonna happen.
Here it comes.
Yeah. We're kissing.
They don't know. They can't see this, right? They can't see this. Have a good week, everyone. Have a good week.
So covered the eyes of the skull as its mouth dropped. Rad started chanting the sacred ancient words. I want a chimera for a son. I want to cast a spell for a son. Yeah, I want a chimera for a son. A son who's like 50 different animals. With that, the ritual was complete. When the haze receded, there stood a 10-foot tall, butt-ass ugly chimera.
Box 41, Fair LaSalle, Pennsylvania, 19030.
We need a sweet jingle to go with that. We need to invent one.
Fair LaSalle, Pennsylvania, 19030, P.O. Box 41, it's fantasy fiction. That's
great.
Well, that's the Stick Stickley one. You remember Stick
he's
Stickley's
dead.
P.O. Box?
We can use that.
No, he's dead. Yeah, he is. I think I remember it. It's write to me, Stick Stickley, P.O. Box 963,
New York City, New York State, 10108. Do you remember Scruff McGruff?
Chicago, Illinois, 60652.
Scruff McGruff, Chicago, Illinois.
60652.
That's where crime happens. Chicago.
Well, that worked. Because Chicago is peaceful.
They wrote and they came. The crime came, Scruff.
Where have you been, Scruff? Come on.
Come on. With that, let's get into some fantasy.
Fantasy, baby.
Baby.
I'm going to lick your lips with my fantasy kiss.
I'm into it. Let's do this. It dug its talons into the orc's back and flew him high into the sky. Then he dropped him to his death. The dog watched the whole thing. I can feel it falling in the air tonight. Don't tell me your dog racist. Ha ha ha! The sorcerer had returned to his tower. I watched that death live and in person because the kangaroo won that fight a long time ago. Badass bald dwarf in a sleeveless battle keg t-shirt walked out of the forest to the stone cold Steve Austin. Dum-dum-dum-dum-dum-dum.
Oh my god.
Wow.
Sorry. Sorry.
The dwarf had a very long gray beard with various scars on his face.
As he finished, another book flew off the shelf. Jimmy picked it up and read the cover. It said, Sexual Healing Techniques. As he opened the book, it began to sing, Ooh, now let's get down tonight. Baby, I'm hot just like a dragon's taint. I need some loving, and baby, I can't hold it much longer. I'm talking about my jizz, girl. And when I get that jizzy feeling, I want sexual healing. Talk about butt stuff, dick all in your beehole. Jimmy quickly closed the book, looked around, and put the book under his arm because, you guessed it, he was going to jerk off to it.
Next scroll!
Next scroll is from Andrew Santos. He asks, what is the national anthem of Orkspire and Daranos?
Well, in Orkspire, I don't believe there is a national anthem, yes. But lucky for all of us and the people of Orkspire, I've written one.
Yes.
It goes like this. Orkspire, you get stabbed in the neck. Orkspire, Orkspire, old snickerdoodle's the best. Orkspire, 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 snickerdoodle for king president.
That is beautiful, snickerdoodle.
Thank you. Yes, it's, well, I'm going to make it official tomorrow.
You're going to give it to them? You're like the Francis Snickerdoodle Key. That's what I'm going to call you.
Yes, yes. I am actually kind of like Prince Moore.
Yes. Well, you have that purple...
In terms of songwriting.
And you have that purple bone cycle.
Mm-hmm.
Which you drive around a lot.
Mm-hmm. How about in Daranos?
In Daranos, we don't have an official one either, but I'll just make one up right now. Oh, Daranos, your comely maidens are so boss. Please let me kiss your wife. I promise to wear a condom. Home of the biggest booties, our land we praise to thee. If you don't, I'll kick your ass, you fucking sack of wet pussy. Finn.
Sack of wet pussy you put in the national anthem.
Yes. It will play during the Wizlympics, and all will know that if you do not praise Daranos, you're a sack of wet pussy.
Brave.
Yes, thank you.
Next roll!
Next roll!
Yes. I don't want to be in the same room with you anymore. This is gross.
You know what they say, Snickerdoodle. Hold on loosely, but don't let go.
They do say that.
If you touch my balls, you're gonna lose control. You're gonna lose control.
They do say that. They do say that. And with that, that's all the information people shall receive. And until next time.
Until next.
That's a lot of beer.
Yeah.
It's a lot of malt liquor.
Yeah.
Yeah. But Josh, until next week.
Until next week. Keep on wizarding.
Keep on wizarding, make your dreams come true by doing the thing that you want to do. Yeah!
Lick a titty and tell your mom about it.
Or punch a dick and tell no one.
Do whatever you want as long as it makes you look fucking cool.
And you will.
See you in 2 weeks, everyone. Have a good week. Have a good 2 weeks. Bye-bye.
Next week,
not next week because it's 2 weeks schedule nowadays. Josh,
until next week, keep on wizarding.
Keep on wizarding till your dreams come true. If your dream is to turn into a frog and then kiss a man, that's a weird dream. I don't know why you dreamed of that.
Don't let anybody fucking tell you how to live your fucking frog life.
Bam, 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 bam. Yeah.
Yeah. Fantasy fiction.
Keep on wizard, everyone. Have a good week. Bye. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye. With that said, guys, thank you so much for listening to another episode. We hope you enjoyed it, and we hope you have a good week. And before we go,
just remember, like the bumper sticker on that Tesla now says, keep on wizarding!
Keep on wizarding down
baby.
The wizard road.
I'm gonna fuck a dude in a wig on the internet.
Come and kiss me, I'm a night elf. And I can turn into a cat.
Keep on wizarding, everyone. Have a good week. We'll see you next time. Today, we're telling tales of crowns and
vagabonds.
Nomad vagabond, call me what you will. Now, 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 now. Now, 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 wherever I may roam. Yeah, yeah. No.
Enter Sandman.
No.
Yeah. Enter Sandman is the ultimate James Hetfield song.
Yeah.
Because it's got both of them, and they're like back to back. But that's Metallica. From that point forward, it's yeah, no, oh.
Fuel and Refuel were just, that was just what they did in those. I can't name you a song off of Fuel.
Fuel.
Give me Fuel, Give Me Fire, yeah.
Self-titled. Well, I guess not self-titled. But
What was that other song? What was the...
Wherever I may roam.
Yeah, that one.
That one? Was it that one?
Yes.
No.
Well, guys, if you're still listening to the show, this late episode where we just sing this James Hetfield impression over and over again.
This is the whole show.
Yeah. Well, stay tuned.
Goodbye.
Thought of it.
Yes.
Let's get into some tales of crowns and
vagabonds. Call me what you will.
That song. I enjoy Black Album.
Oh yeah, Black Album's good. Hey,
I know,
man.
It's the I know it's the album that made people go, Metallica sucks. But no, it's fun.
S&M.
It's got some.
She sees Daryl holding up Taffy Joe sideways like a boombox as he plays Peter Gabriel's In Your Eyes on his harmonica. I don't even know.
That is terrible mouth harmonica. Great story, Josh. Also, those Family Matter Oz forward and pulled back his hood, revealing the face of the same orc who just exploded in front of him.
I'm a motherfucking illusionist. No other dudes can do this. I was also the goblin and a tree earlier. And last week, I was just a knife. A fucking knife. I was a knife for a whole week just chilling in the woods. My name is Trick Friend.
What is it? Trick Friend?
Trick Friend.
Trick Friend.
Damn, said a nearby tree. That's my homie, Hot Man Tree. I'm also that tree, yeah.
Oh my God.
Lightning struck a really delicious looking rock, and the wizard from earlier reappeared and bellowed, You're not celebrating holidays? I hope it snows and you get to go outside and play in it, because that's what I really liked.
Yeah.
So, have a good time.
Keep on Christmasing.
Keep on Christmasing. Have a good week.
Yeah, yeah.
Have a good end of the year. Have a good New Year's as well. Have a safe New Year's. Have a safe holiday, everyone. Have a good time. We'll see you in 2015.
No.
Who got Black Album for Christmas? That kid was sick.
My mom bought my cousin Black Album for Christmas. I remember.
I asked and you had an answer.
I remember.
See everybody.
All right, Dom. Are you ready?
I am ready for some fantasy. Rub it all over my body. See what I do to you.
I'm
with
good.
My lips.
I am going to use that on someone someday. My story is called Courage in the Line of Fire, Armageddon, the Day Darano Stood Still.
Oh, damn. It is. Then the wizard and the crystal steed levitated off into the purple night. Then this song played. There's nobody this bad, and I know you are sad, because you ain't got out on a dick like this. If you want to punch fight me, then you can fucking punch fight me. And then you'll be on the ground looking at my under dick. And your bone will get so hard that your balls will explode. And you will miss the rest of the 2015 sex season. I'll punch your life away. By the way, I got an extra dick. And when I cast spells, I do awesome fighting moves. I'm a bonus dick having black belt in karate. I'll end your life and your life's life. Then I'll be chilling with your white wife, your honky ass bitch motherfucker. The end.
I'm going to say that that's my favorite part of the tale, and that's okay. That was awesome.
The song that was playing in my head that I was making up while I was setting up to record. I was like, that's going into the end. You keep on wizarding over there, girl, and you know that I'm gonna look at this painting and try to act like I'm not looking at you.
If you put some sunglasses on at the beach, you can look at all the titties you want.
Dude, that's why they invented sunglasses.
I don't fucking care if my eyes get sun cancer. I'm gonna look at your booty.
Your cancerous booty. Keep on wizarding, everyone. Have a good week. Thanks for listening, and we'll see you real soon.
Bye. My story this week is called Cat Scratch Fever. I think I named the story that before, but I don't care.
Yeah. Oh, wait, is this the beginning of the story?
No, it's not.
Oh, okay, that's just improv. Okay.
I just wanted to do it.
If I was going to say, if you wrote that, I would hats off, tip of the old hat.
Well, then I totally wrote it.
Oh, okay. Continue. Yeah, don't let me interrupt your story.
The city of Grawl smelled like a dog's taint the day after it had been on a sex bender. We're totally boned, I said. Mew, Buffcat commanded. Rap, but I lost my flow, I said, dejected. Mew! Okay, Ice replied. The cat guard surrounded him as he mustered the strength to let out a sick, nasty rhyme. Y'all know me, I'm the whiz with the big D. Been drinking piss and growl at my trough, but now I'm here kicking it with BC. The cat guard stopped. Pussies, please. Who's a wizard that taught you to eat turds, hang out with Ken Burns, and all see ball marathon Batman Returns? The cat guards began to purr. Now it's time you all drank my pee. Literally, not figuratively. I'm the best wizard rapper since Ice-Z. Oh, wait. That's me. Who's my favorite X-Man? Jubilee!
Oh!
Ice finished as all the cat guards were purring and rubbing themselves up against him. From off screen, a pair of Hello Kitty panties flew at his face. The cursed amulet he was wearing began to glow and an air horn blared.
And edit right there. Let's do it. We're doing wargs and rings.
Sounds good.
Wargs of the rings?
Uh-oh.
Oh. Bingo, bango. Meet me on the internet, baby.
I just like to pick things that people will have to spend money on the toy on.
Yeah.
And the warg is like a, you know, that's like $20.
You got it. I love it. Montgomery, flea market. Remember that guy?
Oh, yeah.
It's just like a mini mouse. Hey, hey.
Yeah, oh my god, wow. You just time traveled me.
Yeah, just go watch it. Honestly, that video holds up. It's real fun. I watch it every now and then. Until next week.
Until next week. Keep on wizarding.
Keep on wizarding. Beanie, 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 beanie. Oh shit, he wrote more. Dude, your story's not over. Keep on wizarding, everyone. Have a good week.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Warg riders, Wolf said Wolfman Stein. Mount up! As they rode off into the distance, they sang their gang's chant. Stop. Drop. Shut them down. Smoke a lot of pot. Hey-o. Oh. That's how warg riders roll. Finn.
That is how warg riders roll.
Also, Vin Diesel movie. That'd be a really good Vin Diesel movie. Saul thought about all the preparation he had done. Squawk boxes were pumping peppy battle dirges over the lot to encourage shopping.
Battle dirges.
Well, let's hear him first. I've never had to knock on wood because I know someone who has. Makes me wonder if I could.
That's the impression
that I get.
This song's about Daranosian AIDS.
I just want to make sure Scott continues on at some point in this fantasy world. Saul was also wearing the leather sales robes his mother left him right before she was taken by the Razorbats. Snacks. You really want to get those grape suckers. Finally, Saul and Charleston had an idea. Cut to bam, pow, bam, wow, 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 wow. It's the Warg Whisperer. Warg Whisperer. Let him in your homes and he'll tame your dangerous steed with his non-threatening ways. Down the street, a caravan of crewmen arrived. They had all seen scrying spheres. I believe you guys call them all-seeing orbs. He came to the evil Warg's cage and clapped his hands rapidly. You need to greet the wargs in a sound that threatens them and throws them off balance. This destroys their aggression. He opened the cage and started chanting, "Hi, ya, 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 ya." Just as he was getting to that part of the song, they forgot. The evil warg chomped down on Thrall, ripping
Return to innocence.
That's the only part anyone remembers. As soon as you get to Return to Innocence, everyone forgets. So as soon as he gets to that part,
and then it goes truth. It must shine.
Dude,
actually,
yeah.
I feel like there's like a 90% chance you guys have already used that song in fantasy fiction, but it just felt.
We used it in something else that I can't tell you what it's from.
Every day of my life.
It's so good. It's so good, and it's great how white people ripped off Native Americans for their music. It's pretty awesome.
Yeah, it's pretty great.
Anyway, just as he was getting to that part of the song that I forget, the evil warg chomped down on Thrall, ripping his head and spine from his body.
I feel a return to innocence after hearing this tale.
We'll be played forever in every Hallmark store forever.
Awesome.
This one is called Ring a Ding Dong.
Oh yeah, ring ding dong,
ring a ding 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 dong. Keep the heads ringing. Okay, all right. A tall troll fighter was badly limping through the gore tusk, decapitating all kinds of orcs. Suddenly, a songbook stood on a tiny rock nearby and began to sing. Ring heroes,
Ring heroes, fucking guys riding around on wargs. They got magic rings in the Gortusk Highlands, the land where it's basically a 24/7 showdown. Kinda like how my life is a 24/7 bro-down. Somebody call my mom and tell her I take drugs. Somebody fucking tell my mom that I fucking take drugs. I take drugs and I shoot downtown to my natural body and just let my body be free. I let myself be me. I'll be chilling ass bow with my BBC, yeah. BBC, yeah. S&D, yeah. Chilling with me, yeah. A song with a black ass dick, yeah. Oh my God.
That Dom, I just want to bring up, we both said that we have black dicks in our stories.
Why? Josh, what? 50 episodes we've been doing this.
Dude.
Why do we always kind of write about the same thing?
I don't know. And we also brought up two Fast and the Furious episode movie titles.
Two different movies. Two different Fast and Furious movies.
That's
guys,
so
I
weird.
I don't want to jinx it, but I mean, like, I didn't mention it, but Imperium.
Yeah.
Two big black dicks.
Dude. There it is. Oh. That's true.
The songbug's black dick was hanging on a sweet chariot, but was not noticed on this day because the most extreme beams were shooting out of rings and exploding dudes' lives away.
You have been.
Like that shot at the end of Return of the Jedi where there's just a bunch of ghost dads staring at you.
Yeah. Okay, go ahead.
I want to ask you guys, in case I didn't ask you already, what have you guys feel like you've learned? Like, what have you guys learned about each other? What have you learned about your writing?
Relaxed and put his all-C headphones on his ears. Slow Ride began to play as he closed his eyes. Wizards smoking weedsy. Wizards suck on these nuts. Finn.
Oh my gosh, Josh. That was a great story.
Thank
that was
you.
Fantastic.
Thank you.
Hi. Too late. Dwarf Sun began to glow gold and float.
Whoa.
As he did, something sang. He is the Sausage Prince. He is actually a real ass prince. You thought it was all made up, but this boy can season some sausage. The satchel floated over to the dwarf son, and the two landed. We did it! I retrieved the satchel! My life will slightly improve! Thank you, Goblin!
Until next week! Keep on wizarding!
Keep on wizarding! Sometimes you look at yourself in the mirror and you say, I don't know if I could do it today, but you can.
Because you look at
just got a wizard.
You're a wizard, Harry.
Come to Hogwarts. And fucking get BDNWP.
Finger some witch babes. You know he
Finger
did.
Finger maybe a ghost.
He took a bath with that ghost. I mean, Jesus.
Oh, damn. That's right. Forward. All eyes were on him. He knelt and just started doing some capoeira as Boom, I Got Your Boyfriend by MC Lush.
Dude, MC, yes. Boom, I Got Your Boyfriend. Dude, I love that song.
Boom, I Got Your Boyfriend. I Got Your Man.
I got him.
Dude, that's what was happening. Just that song's playing as some fucking orchestra doing capoeira. The beast was enthralled. The way this orc could move his body was incredible. Everyone was Ricard as he pulled the dagger back. Suddenly, a songbug stood on a tiny rock. Everyone got quiet. The lights went down. He sang, who wants to live forever? Who wants to live forever? That's right, ladies and gentlemen, spoke the songbug in the manliest voice where you could almost hear the counterweight of his long donger. I, too, drank from this ancient potion.
Oh, no.
I am immortal.
What? Songbug's immortal?
But there is no record of anyone claiming the potion, shouted an orc.
It's just like that song I wrote called Neglect Me Not, he continued, and he began to sing.
Father of mine, tell me where have you been? You know, I just closed my eyes and the whole world disappeared because I was two and you abandoned me and I didn't have object permanence yet. It wasn't easy for me being a scared orc boy in a troll neighborhood. This went on for 17 long Inagata Davida-esque minutes. Everyone hated it.
That's my nightmare, an extended version of that song.
Of Father of Mine.
Oh my god.
That'd be terrible. Evelyn saw how much this meant to him. Plus, she just wanted him to stop. All right. When the smoke cleared, there stood a wizard.
Father of mine.
That started playing because it was the next song on the CD, but then we had to stop it.
Hit a mixtape for road trips. Mix CD.
Hello there, young adventurers, he said cheerily.
All right, Josh, this one's called Two Mimics to Midnight.
both of our stories were titled after songs.
After songs, that's really...
Which isn't too crazy, but hey.
We do that a lot.
We are in sync.
We are in sync.
In sync. The new one.
Yeah.
We started it. Look for a new album next year. Okay.
Album drops in the fall.
It was near midnight in Orkspire as people faded and never woke up.
Wagula.
It's back.
Wagula's back.
Wagula. Hey, yeah, I'm a Wagula.
I'm like mixing two songs up.
Wagula of mine. Tell me where have you moved? Been?
When the dwarves arrived, they found the tower's doors wide open. The tower got Josh's mom, you guys.
It got her pregnant and then killed her.
Mother of mine, I know your Facebook. How'd you fuck my mom with your Facebook looking dick?
It's weird blue. Yeah.
It looks like the F. It's like the same shape.
It's hooked.
Ah! It's got barbs on it. Ah, Jesus.
Hooked and ridged, apparently.
Ah, fuck.
But once again, guys, thank you so much for supporting the show.
Yes.
Gosh.
Until next week, everyone. Keep on wizarding.
Keep on wizarding.
Baby.
You know I missed you, Dad.
I love you, Dad. I think I've never met you. But I wonder if you was ever real. I'm so toasted on that dumb.
I was earlier. That's what I do on Sundays. Smoke weed, get breakfast. Do it. It's change your life.
Yeah, man. Just fuck the police. Soon the gnomes were sitting around the pentagram chanting ancient arcane and mysterious incantations. In unison, they began to speak the magic words. Everybody get up. It's time to live now. We got a jam. We got a real jam going down. Welcome to the seance jam. Here's your chance. Do your dance. It's the seance jam. All right. As they spoke the ancient words, a purple mist began to fill the area as the moons began to align and turn a deep dark red.
Of the end of time for all time, said the pantsless zombie in a booming voice, probably enhanced by the confidence given to him from not wearing pants like a boss.
Minions, shouted Rory, I command you.
But suddenly a familiar tune began to play. It started out faint. Come on, ride the train and ride it, choo choo. Then it got louder. Come on, ride the train and ride it, and still louder yet. Come on, ride the train, it's a choo-choo train. The gnomes looked over to see Oreo singing along to all C-tube videos on his all-sea ball.
Your bidding will be done, my lord, said the pantsless zombie.
What? I didn't give you any orders yet, Rory shouted.
Suddenly, the zombies began to form a conga line and sing along.
Come on, ride the train. Hey, ride it, choo-choo. They sang as they began to dance and move in unison to the killer jam. They formed a line of hundreds of zombies, maybe thousands, into the distance and began to ride the train. Some put their hands up and pretended to pull the choo-choo train cord, while Pantsless Zombie began to pop and lock like an old pro, probably due to the fact he was unrestricted from the pants which society tells us we have to wear.
Again, a great point. Popping and locking is way easier naked.
Yes.
Your body.
Exactly. Maybe I'll just get myself taxidermied into a popping and locking pose.
And people into an animatronic.
Yeah, you can put me in Disney World.
Yeah, put me in Pirates.
Yeah. I think I can. The zombies sang, moving slowly yet relentlessly off into the horizon. Some say, to this day at night, when you hear a train, that it's the ghosts of the zombies still marching into oblivion, doing the train. I think I can. The gnomes were silent in their defeat, except for Oreo, who was still jamming out. From underground, a voice could be heard.
Fiction. And Josh, thank you for being my friend.
Thank you for being my friend. Round the Dom, and I love Dom.
Oh, yeah.
You got a Dom of gold. You're a friend, and your name is Dom.
Thank you. I am that guy. Hey, you know what I actually was doing this week?
What?
I was listening to some Steely Dan.
Really? All of the Steely Dan discography.
You going back, Jack. Do it again.
You know who's
we're
a good...
going round and round.
You know who's a good band that I think is the whitest band I listen to?
What's that?
The Doobie Brothers.
Dude, the Doobie Brothers are good.
Yeah, man. If you ever want
to... It will come back to you.
Uh-huh.
That's Michael McDonald on that track.
Yeah, right? Man. Yeah, dude.
Yeah.
You can tell. He's got
You can tell. He's in there. Just listen. Next time you hear Peg...
Mm-hmm.
You listen closely, you'll hear some McDonald right in there. What's another one they do? Oh. What's the other Michael McDonald, like...
Oh. Din, 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 din. Something don't
only
lose.
A fool believes. Yeah. That one. Yeah.
Our friend Mike does a really good Michael McDonald impression.
I believe it. I believe that. I really do.
It's spot on, man. It's great. Until next week, everybody, keep on wizarding!
Keep on wizarding! I see you being a shark in my life!
Keep on wizarding, baby! That's the best I got.
I love it. I love it. Keep on wizarding, everybody. Have a good week. We'll see you next week.
Bye! It's almost like the Mickey Mouse song. Oh, your name's great.
It's kind, you know what? It kind of is like that. I'm going to start doing it that way.
M-O-S-C-H-I-T-T-I is my name.
Anyway, we are here with tales of Warlock.
Skeleton. Some say it sounded like the beginning of Billy Squire's The Stroke. Stroke me, I'm killing Skeleton. Sid sang as he shoved both daggers in the eye sockets of a Skeleton. Oh my god, not my not eyes, he shouted. She had complete control of the Skeleton and began to control his every movement. Hello, my baby. Hello, my darling. Hello, my ragtime gal. The Skeleton sang as Ugla made him dance right off the edge of the mountain.
An appropriate spell. Combination of both saying and execution.
As the two entered the one-room shack, they could smell the smells of a thousand deaths. Into another episode, and keep on wizarding!
Keep on wizarding! I never looked into your eyes like this. I think I might say I love you. But I gotta save myself for the wizard in my room. Don't know what that means. Okay, have a good week, everyone.
Bye.
Until next week.
Keep on wizarding.
Keep on wizarding. Don't walk down the road and look behind your back and see an Illuminati eye. Don't do that.
Just don't do that.
Keep on wizarding, everybody.
See you next
week. Have a good week, and we'll see you next week, hopefully.
Bye.
He began playing the flute so good it made all the forest critters come out and swoon, and it was like this. And then a little chipmunk was like, "Do you think me?" Look, dude, vampire, I don't want to sound like a jerk, but you smell really bad and you're ugly as shit, and when I look at you I want to do evil stuff like straight up dropping 712 on your ass. Fingren began to play his flute. It was beautiful, and it sounded just like this. Sweet dreams of rhythm and passion. Sweet dreams of dancing through the night. Sweet dreams
take you over.
Dancing through the night.
Oh yeah.
This is the rhythm of the night.
Oh, night.
The night.
That's like the Cher version.
This is the rhythm of the night. It transitioned into that pretty easily.
Dude, he's like a mixologist, a remix artist.
Yeah, in the background, it was like, clue, 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 clue. Its beauty caught Lord Balaam off guard, and he almost dropped a stick.
Oh, shit.
Almost. The ground began to shake. What were you doing? Were you?
I don't remember. I have no idea.
I imagine you were. Yeah, I just imagine it was dancing.
It might have been something like that. I don't remember.
It was sweet dreams of rhythm and dancing.
I don't know the words. I'm just making
Me
them.
Me neither. I don't know if I know the words. What's that other song? Oh yeah,
yeah. Wanna be my lover?
Oh yeah. I was listening to a lot of that music this week, and I was talking with my girlfriend Corey about it.
Thanks for listening. See you Monday, and keep on wizarding.
Oh yeah,
gonna keep on wizarding.
Oh yeah. Yeah, gotta keep on wizarding. Thank you. See you next week, everyone. Bye-bye.
Bye.
The soothsayer lit more candles, red ones this time. She placed the skull in the center of the pentagram and chanted the magic words.
Yes.
Oh yes, I must confess, I'm gonna be your lover. This went on. You get it. The soothsayer's eyes turned bright blue as she recoiled and cringed at everything she saw. Make Josh laugh, and I know you do the same for me.
Mm-hmm.
We're good friends. We do a great job. I'm glad we're doing this. And I'm
be
glad...
my lover, won't you be my
lover? Oh, yeah.
Gonna be my lover.
La da da dee da 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 da.
We still haven't gotten that out of our system.
We still haven't gotten that out of our heads, guys. And you never will. You never will. I don't know what that was. Hey, if you guys want to send us an email, please do. Fantasyfic1.
Yes.
So if you wanted to send us something, that's it. P.O. Box 935, Montrose, California, 91021.
We need a jingle for that.
Write to me. Fantasy Fiction, P.O. Box 935, Montrose, California, 91021. That's the stick stick.
Be my lover, won't you be
my lover? All right, let me try that. Fantasy Fiction, P.O. Box 935.
Oh, yeah.
Montrose, California. Oh, yeah.
There it is.
91021.
That was beautiful.
Thank you.
That was beautiful.
Thank you. I'm good. I'm good at saying.
I'm good at talk.
What else do we got? Out.
Get out.
My life.
and be a simple kind of wizard. Or be like something cool like a dragon or an elf man or a man lizard. He sang to himself. Then he leaned over the sink and started to blow snot out of his gross wizard nose for like an uncomfortable amount of time.
Montage song. Your favorite.
Your favorite. Whatever one that is. Favorite. Yeah.
You know what it is for me.
What's yours?
The heat is
I have a really vivid memory of being a child and sitting in my mom's Chevy Citation listening to that song.
Nice. I sang that at karaoke recently. I loved it.
Dude, I love that song. Glenn Fry.
Karaoke. But the final two combatants were in the ring, Josh. The Great Thule and Malamo with the little wizard hype man.
Everyone, keep on wizarding. Go see Mad Max.
Keep on wizarding. If you ever want to stop, just remember the review by Sick Ass Orc Wank.
Sick. Jizz and stuff is totally a word.
It's one word.
Are you listening?
Look it up in Webster's. Jizzionary.
Holy shit. Jizzionary? Dude. We're making that.
Go ahead and buy Urban Dictionary and change it to Jizzionary.
Yeah, that's basically what it is, right?
Rebranding, folks. Keep on wizarding, everybody. Have a good week. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.
BBCCC.
We ain't ever gonna tell you that.
No one's gonna know, or somebody might figure it out.
You can deduce it. You can figure it out.
It's not hard.
Well, what do you say we get into some fantasy here? What do you say?
Let's do it.
All right.
How to be the man.
How to be the boss. How to come through with seven coats of the claws. That's the song. Okay, let's do it.
Please stand and remove your helms for the Daranos National Anthem as performed by Daranos' own Ludacrits.
Daranos is the best continent. We have all the very best condiments. Comely maidens grow on trees here. Yes, that's right. You can have sex with trees here. Huge tits, large tits, medium tits, small tits, dope tits. Rope tits, quest tits, the best tits.
Okay, we get the point. Let the drinking games begin.
That Ludacrits.
He really knows how to sing
a
minute.
He really knows how to play to a crowd.
It was like Whitney Houston at the Super Bowl.
It was just like Whitney Houston at the Super Bowl.
Of course, as always, the winner will receive the amethyst.
Randall quickly realized he was in a mind dungeon.
What?
Mind dungeon.
What?
Mind dungeon. You're in a motherfucking mind dungeon, boy. You'll have to fight. You'll have to fight with your mind. Can you even do that? What does that even mean? Mind dungeon. It's a mind dungeon song. That's what it's a ceremonial mind dungeon song ended.
Holy shit. Holy shit.
War drums began to beat as hordes of beast monsters wielding clubs and bone clubs. Oh, they went around.
Holy shit.
Oh, they went around. And then this song played. Do, do, do,
do, do, do, do. Oh, yeah.
Do, 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 bam, 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 bam.
Oh, fuck, man.
Regulators!
Mount up!
Randall's just saying this, by the way. He's saying, regulators!
Dude, yeah.
Mount up! It was a cool back then.
Randall does.
If I could have wings, I could fly.
Yes! Holy shit. Oh my god. Oh, I gotta breathe. Hold on.
This show will now feature freestyle raps about Josh's Uncle Bill.
He's bald.
There was a spooky vampire bat on Josh's windowsill.
It was on my back. He came in.
It was on his back. It was on his back, and his Uncle Bill
came and he rescued me. Cause I'm a wiener boy and I don't want to touch no bat.
Just two hot wiener boys don't want to get messy.
Don't want to get that rabies, son.
I don't want to get sick by getting bit by a bat.
You gotta get a needle in your stomach.
Gotta get 17 needles in your stomach.
Don't want to fucking live that life.
I fucking killed that life. Rap game.
We are good at this.
We got this. We
don't even need to rhyme. That's what rappers do now. They don't rhyme.
They don't rhyme anymore.
They don't have to.
Out the window.
Yeah. It's like a spoken word.
You know what? About one of the things we brought up, or if you just wanted to say, hey, I want to talk about Laffy Taffy jokes.
Yeah, get that Laffy Taffy. Get that Laffy Taffy. Remember that song?
Gonna miss every taffy. I'm gonna meet every taffy.
Yeah. Yep, that's really good.
I'll meet you at the candy store.
Take you to the candy shop.
Guys, this isn't a show where we parody rap songs, but if it was...
It could be.
If it was,
uh-huh.
You bet we'd be...
Number one.
Okay at it.
We'd be mediocre.
Mediocre.
We're listening and keep on, Wizard.
Keep on wizarding. If you ever looked under your bed and you see an old man, guess what? You're in a Metallica video. Keep on wizarding, everyone. Have a good weekend. We'll talk to you real soon.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Whatever. Garcon had recently joined up with Zeke, but the two were already making a name for themselves throughout the land as the most famous smugglers in Darinos. They even already had a theme song. Just some magical boys, never doing no harm. Except for that one time when they killed that witch, and when they stepped on that baby, but the baby was a ghost and he was evil as hell. It's going to be okay, little buddy, Zeke reassured his companion as he shifted into 69th gear. Sir Mace Cop. He's been after me.
P.O.D.s.
They're back.
They're back.
Don't you want to do. I don't know the words to that song.
Bad boys.
What you gonna do? He's been after me for a fortnight, ever since I smuggled my bone car into his mother's wizard hole, if you know what I mean.
Oh.
I was chanting the words for the freeze time spell. Hey, you knocked that off, yelled Garcon defiantly, but the paladin kept on chanting. Feels like a froze time. Feels like a fucking froze time.
Feels like a fucking froze time.
Finally, Garcon had enough. He pulled out his enchanted plastic drink sword.
In 2 weeks, and until then, Josh.
Until then, thank you for listening, and keep on wizarding.
Keep on wizarding down the road. Just the good old boys.
Just some magical boys.
Just the magical boys. Never doing no harm. Been in trouble with the laws of gravity since the day they've been born. That works though, because your guys fell off a mountain.
Yep.
Keep on wizarding, everybody. We'll see you next time. Have a good week. Have a good 2 weeks. Enjoy the summer. Bye
bye.
Now, what do you say?
Oh yeah.
For tales of basilisks and
stroke me.
All right, let's do it.
It went by. Suddenly, one of the skeletons looked directly at the camera and began to sing. I close my eyes only for a moment, but Spoontown's gone. Why didn't we name it something better? We didn't even make spoons here. What the fuck were we thinking? Suddenly back in the candle shop hideout, there was a knock on the door.
To his lips and played the most magical song he knew. Yeah. As he did, a songbug stood atop a rock that had lost a couple friends and began to sing. Would you know, my dog, if my dick went to heaven, would you give my dick a funeral? If my dick died drunk driving, I must be strong and chew my dong. Cause if Obama gets re-elected, I'll rip my dick off.
Man, Songbug. Now we know his politics. Also, why the fuck is this dick drunk driving?
Why is this my dick that drunk driving?
I think if Eric Clapton heard that song, he would be very proud, Dom.
He would cry.
Yeah.
He would cry just like this basilisk. The basilisk burst into tears after hearing the sad song about a bug's dick.
But since his eyes were deadly, his time until next week, Josh.
Until next week. Keep on wizarding.
Keep on wizarding. I meant to say 2 weeks.
Everybody should know by now.
If you don't know that by now, you will never have a dick accident. Keep on wizarding, everyone. Have a good week. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Great. Starts off with a prologue.
Well, it was the dudes who fought and dudes who won. Dudes who beat up everyone. There was heavy dude attitude. I tell you, man, some dudes was nude. It was the dueling dudes of the Ice Vikings.
Fucking awesome.
You don't get a lot of sung prologues in books these days.
No, you know what? I couldn't think of one in the last 5 years.
Yeah.
So I was moved.
It was maybe 11 p.m. in Orkspire. Glacier walked away into the ice set.
What?
The dudes had dueled. Some dudes had won. Some dudes had lost, but dudes had fun. Some dudes cried because some friends died. Why did it have to be a duel to the death? Could have figured out a better plan. Maybe people could have voted or something. I could think of at least 100 different ways to settle this instead of killing each other. And then paying me 10,000 gold to write these awesome songs to record the whole thing. Whose idiot idea was this? It's honestly better if Orkmanity didn't remember.
All of a sudden, the ice horn. All of a sudden, the ice horn reformed like the T-1000, and everyone was shocked.
What?
Especially when it said, "Duel, you dudes," and the dueling continued.
Oh my god!
The end.
What?
Yeah, I get why that book's so popular now.
Yeah, it's good. Until then.
Until then, thank you, everyone, and keep on wizard hanging.
Keep on wizard hanging. I hope you don't read the title and think of a wizard genocide. Because we hanged all the wizards.
Wizard hang means get your dick out.
Whoa.
Just let it fly.
Let it hang down with the stank town. Keep on wizarding, everybody. We'll see you next week. And until then, keep on wizarding, everybody. Have a good one. We'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.
First gems and pyromancers.
Pyromancers.
See you there.
See you on the other side.
See you on the other side.
If that's not a song, could it please be a song?
I think it's Ozzy. I think Ozzy does that.
Oh, okay.
It's one of the Ozzy songs.
Well then, it is a song. So let's go.
All pyromancer band. fire in the second hole started wailing their hit tune, God Damn We Love Fire, which went like this.
We didn't start the fire. Oh, yes, we did, because we fucking love some fire. Flyman, FDR, Sid the Rogue, Bone Card, Snickerdoodle, Milks, MLK, Stinkline, did you hear that Throm's gay? Druid, Jimmy, Bapple Chair, Ludacris, hey, you quiet down there? Steak Daddy, Old Skins, Old Buff Cat, fuck it, let's just fuck some gold. As they played, everyone faked like they knew the lyrics until the fire-powered monster truck just drove right the fuck over the stage like it was a VW fur beetle, crushing everyone and killing them all.
Oh, man.
That was a good band while it lasted.
Good concert.
All around, people were starting fire orgies.
Topaz, it was just... eyes wide in. As he froze in place, suddenly he sang... It's the topaz of Tupaca. It's so magical. I'm gonna put it in my pee hole. And then I'm gonna call my dad. Tell him what I did. Tell him I don't take shit anymore. Cause I'm a man now.
He's gonna call his dad and tell him he's stuck in a cursed gem in his pee hole.
Bindle then lit himself on fire. Dill tried to sneak in the room and grab the topaz.
Gotta say this. Uh-huh. If it's a dance audition,
yeah,
and someone shows up late, you know they're gonna let them try out because they're like, oh my god, this could be magic.
Yeah, that's what you do, right? That's like how it happens in the movies.
Am I too late?
No.
Yes, but let's just go ahead.
Yeah, go ahead. And they're like, packing up, yeah.
What a feeling. Da, 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 da. What a feeling. And we're just, you and I are the judges, and we're just like, holy shit.
We're blown away.
I'm sweating. It's so good.
I'm crying.
We're just both getting water out of ourselves because your dance was so good,
yeah.
Guys.
Yeah.
That's what it's like to read your prize. Guys, Battle Keg shirts are back in. Talk about our tales of blood magic and nightmare. Welcome to it.
That's right.
Skin and bone.
Joey Pizza.
Well, you're in the pain mines again.
The motherfucking pain mines again. There's no fucking escape this time. I'm trapped in a pain mine, baby.
Somebody stop me.
There it is. First single.
I hope you've recorded it.
The other thing that I really like about that, the soundtrack is amazing. It's one of the best video game soundtracks.
There's a song on it that goes,
welcome to my nightmare.
I think you're gonna Dracula.
Damn.
It's like not the guy is not saying damn. It's a guitar note going, but it sounds like,
yeah,
damn.
Yeah, it sounds like damn, but it's tuned to the dude.
Yeah.
Damn.
Like it's a transition from the note on the guitar
to the singing
to another note, but it's not a note. It's a guy screaming damn,
dude.
At that note. Yes.
God damn.
Is that how Damn Yankees was created? Is that the origin story? I'll see that.
Find out next time on Fantasy Fiction.
Straight out of Yankees. Let's go. Anyway, I've been playing a lot of Castlevania because I've been...
Have a good week, everyone, and keep on 69ing!
Oh, whoa!
Change it up. I'm doing the robot.
I'm not going to say no. Keep on wizarding, everyone. I'm just going to say that one.
That one.
Keep on wizarding. Have a good week, everyone. We'll see you in 2 weeks on the 69th episode.
Oh,
bye-bye.
Baby.
Gosh, say goodbye.
Goodbye, baby.
Let's get into some stories, Josh.
Is that a flute? Are you playing a flute?
Yeah, it was.
It's like a glissando on that.
If you're roller skating right now and you're listening to this song, came on, this is the roller skating song. Also, Grease, the songs from Grease. They're roller skating songs. Let's get into the real fantasy world, Josh. Let's go.
The play Grease.
The movie Grease.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
With songs from the play. No, Grease Landing is like a roller skating song.
I've never thought that, but I...
Well, you haven't lived. You sack of dirt.
Motherfucking shit in balance as fuck. You're just what I weeded. Saying hi, Templar Dankthar, as he ripped a huge pull off of a spliff and blew out the smoke in the shape of one of those 3D pictures where the answer was the secret to all existence.
Oh my god. Oh my magic eyes.
Magic eye. I couldn't remember the name of it. Thank you. I should have fact checked before it. All around him were marble fixtures and stairs and all kinds.
He stood in front of a tree and punched it repeatedly. A songbug stood on a nearby rock and began to sing. I know I should have killed you right from the start. If it can bleed, we can stick its heart. And you know I'm getting older. And my dick is getting longer. And my dick is getting wiser. And my dick can fucking make a phone call.
It's so symbolic. It's so symbolic of him training. It actually, like, makes perfect fucking sense. I mean, not the phone call part, but, you know.
Everything else. With one last punch and a 3-camera slow motion replay, the tree fell and definitely made a goddamn sound, you deep thinking ass. Songbug hopped on his shoulder and the two sped off into the forest and the songbug sang. It's the dagger's edge. It's gonna get you in the end. I ride 110 on the highway of revenge.
God damn, that's awesome.
I have to admit, I considered getting dick implants.
He's just gotta get some stuff off his chest, man.
He had to come clean about it. He had to admit that he considered getting implants in his penis. Yeah.
It's like a cleansing.
It is like a cleansing. But like let's just keep... We're going to keep going.
Just keep going.
Sweat fell from the brow of Dale Wimbeam as he threw a never-before-heard Pearl Jam song called Can You Hear the Monsters Mash? Began to play, and it sounded like this.
Can you hear the monsters mash? Can you hear the monsters mash? Can you hear the monsters mash?
My favorite thing is that Pearl Jam now exists in Arcsfire.
Never before heard, which means Pearl Jam is interdimensional, and they write songs specifically for Darinos. The first one was called Can You Hear the Monsters Mash?
Can you hear the monsters mash?
Dagger roared toward the city on his Harley Douglas fur. He could feel.
It's the 69th episode. If you ever want to feel old, just think about 2 years ago when you were so young.
You're so much older now. You learned so much about some elves. It's a kind
you
of a rhyme.
You learned something about an orc or an elf or a barbarian.
Oh, man. It's like, god damn. It's like I can, like, see you just making sweet love to that microphone.
It's like a Pearl Jam concert.
God damn it.
That was actually another
Another import.
Another never-before-heard Pearl Jam song.
These are all good.
This is the best episode we've ever done.
It is.
Just gold. Everything. Gold. Guys, thank you for listening to another episode of Fantasy Fiction. Thank you for supporting us. Right. Yeah, so.
Thank you again, everybody, and keep on 2 years of wizarding.
Keep on wizarding for 2 years. You've been doing it for 2 years, so do it 2 years more.
It's a bass drum.
Oh, that was good.
Thanks.
Thanks, everybody. We'll talk soon. See ya. Bye-bye.
Bye.
In quite the time.
Welcome to the Chamber of Knowledge-fornia.
It's gonna be a lovely place.
Such a lovely place.
And I kissed your face.
I hope you kiss my face.
Give me a kiss, I'm a little kissing baby. French me on my lips. Kiss me on my tits. Yeah, I got two of them, babies.
Beautiful.
And this is why this is a bad song, by the way. It's weird.
Yes, it's very sexual. It just turns, like, instantly.
It's over. So if you're listening to this on YouTube and you have a prompt for us, leave it in the comments.
Write a prompt. Let me hear it. Write a prompt.
Let me hear your prompt. What is that sound like? What is that song? How's that song go where it's like, nay, watch me.
Watch me nay nay. Yeah, yeah.
Watch me nay nay.
Watch me whip.
We watch were singing me prompt.
We were singing it this
Watch
weekend.
Me pick them.
Watch me pick them.
Now break your leg. I think it's so funny that there's a song that just telling people to break their leg.
Yeah.
Like, over and over again. It just, the context of it is kind of funny. But those prompts were pulled from YouTube, guys, and they were voted on. It's like 2 o'clock. But until next week, you can keep on wizarding.
Yeah. Keep on wizarding. See you in your nightmares.
Oh my god.
Ghosts are real.
That's one. That's not even Josh.
I gotta go.
See ya.
Bye. Across the stage to the entrance as a sick guitar riff boomed, playing Death Eagle's theme song, which went something like this.
Death Eagle is the night! Death Eagle gonna fight you all night! Death Eagle is a knight with a K! Fight night, death night, night fight! Alright!
As Death Eagle came out, awesome dank smoke was blowing all around from Dankzilla as Death Eagle's robes were looking super cool and glistening with all the loot from the dungeon's coffers.